drying up as a result of low levels of artesian wells. The low shallow wells are also drying up. And this poses a lot of challenge for water for domestic as well as for animal consumption. We have scarcity of pasture as a result of prolonged drought. We have the problem of emaciated livestock and even human beings. We are staring at a disaster in Mandera South. In fact, I was told that in some villages around Elwa, there were some reported cases of death. People are dying from hunger. The problem of, again, this drought has caused a unique challenge, specific normally to the nomadic way of life. Now that there is no pasture, people go very long distances looking for pastures. And that has a possible potential of pitting communities, neighboring communities against one another, and therefore rising cases of conflict between neighboring communities is something now we are getting to hear, that there is a very big tension as a result of people looking for water and pasture. And all this coupled with the insecurity which already exists, the people of Mandera South are in dire need of government support. We are urging national government intervention through different agencies, whether it is through the military, through the NYS, those through the ASAL ministry, to move with speed in order to help the community at least to get some relief in terms of food relief, in terms of water booster, and in terms of other supports. We are supposed to also, as members of parliament, through our emergency kit, which is about 6 million shillings, to be able to help some very dire situation. Unfortunately, our hands are tied because these monies have not been disbursed. We are in 3/4 of the year into the financial year, and Mandera South has only received 9 million shillings. That is a paltry 10% or less. And so we are urging the National Treasury to move with speed to assist these communities